The Edgewater Gallery in Fort Bragg, California, on the coast, is one of the leading venues for talented local artists and opened its doors in 2003. Let's take a look inside. The Edgewater is a cooperative exhibiting several different types of art, including oil, acrylic, and watercolor paintings, sculpture art, fine art photography, handcrafted burlwood tables and bowls, ceramic creations, silver and precious stone jewelry, and whimsical kites.
How did Edgewater Gallery begin?
35 years ago, maybe 40 years ago, my mother-in-law bought that, and it was called the Flying Bear Candy Store. And the reason it was called the Flying Bear is because the person that had bought that was an actor, a stuntman, and he was thrown up in the air, and his last name was Bear. My mother-in-law's building, rather. And then when she passed, then we inherited it. And then it became the art gallery downstairs. I love it, it's so wonderful. And so much has to do with the members. Their work is so good. And I like everyone so much individually. I feel like it's my artist family.
Nino Villamore has been sculpting and drawing since she was 13. A native Californian, she began her art studies at the California College of Arts and Crafts. Following years of study and teaching, she returned to Northern California and is now becoming a part of the Mendocino County arts community. Since 1998, Nino has been casting her original modeling clay images into handmade paper. Cast paper sculptures are original low-relief and freestanding sculptures created using modeling clay, which then have molds created from them. Since an image is only cast on demand, each casting is an individualized piece of artwork, which means the addition is a multiple original. This allows for customizing an image for a client. Chris Hagee creates abstract mixed media pieces on wood panels. She uses everything she can find with interesting texture or lines, and she incorporates gold leaf, aluminum, stencils, and patterns created on different types of paper into her work. Each piece is initiated with an identified color palette and composition idea. Chris loves how shapes, lines, color, and value interact with textures. The goal is to construct something with these materials that appeals to a viewer's eye and provides a sense of hope and enthusiasm. References to actual environments or figures have emerged in her later pieces. Barbara Bernardi is one of our most diversified artists. She works as a fine art artist, glass designer, and has an amazing jewelry line. Her art is colorful and vibrant. She creates her own fusible glass to make one-of-a-kind necklaces, pendants, earrings, and bracelets, using sterling and fine silver in many designs. Several of her pieces incorporate precious stones and a variety of pearls collected from her various trips abroad. Bernardi's art seems to echo and complement the jewelry she designs. Her 2D works of art mediums are in watercolor, fluid acrylic, oil, and mixed media. She is a master at telling subtle stories with her art about time, beauty, and secrets. Bernardi's art is a beautiful complement to anyone's home living environment, and her jewelry designs find customers boasting that when they wear one of her one-of-a-kind pieces, they always seem to capture someone's eye. Greg Burdick is a woodworker dealing primarily with redwood burl, which is an unusual growth normally found in the root of a tree. When sanded and polished, rare and beautiful grains are exposed. Greg makes coffee tables and two-tiered tables and redwood bowls. The wood is local from Fort Bragg area beaches, forests, and timber company lands. Greg uses tung oil for his tables, and the bowls are specially treated with mineral and walnut oil, rendering them ideal for display and for serving food. He has great fun creating the wow factor in his work, and the wood lasts forever. Esther Siegel's composition combines assemblage with book art, creating pieces that are a mixture of both the whimsical and some dark humor. She gets her inspiration from visual resources such as books and other people's work, as well as from her impressive collection of stuff in the studio barn. From broken musical instruments, found birds' nests, jewelry, and such, each piece is unique and stands by itself as a one-of-a-kind creation. Patricia Breed's paintings reflect her belief that the core of our consciousness is love. Inspired by the poetry of Rumi and Hasif, she weaves color into the shape and form of mystic concepts. One of her newest paintings manifested after hearing a woman speak at a storyteller's event. "I've just been diagnosed with stage 4 cancer," the elderly woman said. "I don't have long to live, but before I die, I want to become love." The image of becoming love is symbolized in the painting, "She Who Loves All Things." Much of her work is done with oil colors. There is nothing that compares to the smell and feel as color flows onto the canvas. Images emerge and evolve into a visual poem. While painting, I experience a oneness, a connection with a deeper reality of self. Art, for me, is to connect into the all-embracing presence of creativity. Russ Kristoff's work involves more than just capturing an image. It's a matter of interpretation, giving it a sense of moment. There's a reason or story behind each of the photographs he exhibits. As an award-winning videographer and photographer, he understands that the concept of time in an image is crucial. When he presents a photograph, he'd like to have the viewer tell him what they feel rather than just what they see. His unique work, featuring the North Coast, is meant to evoke dreamlike images, which will stir a memory, create a dream, or take the viewer to another place. These images are also available as hybrid dye-infused metal prints, which glow with a vibrancy and brilliance unparalleled by any other method and can be displayed outdoors as well as indoors. They're waterproof, scratch-resistant, easily cleaned with a moist, soft cloth, and have superior archival value. Russ's newest photographs are titled Impressions, which have the look of watercolor art and are framed under glass or double matted. Joseph Duvivier has been painting oils since, well, forever, like 1985. His main focus is on the effects of light and how we perceive it. He paints from life, not from photos, and in fact does not use photos to make the reproductions of his work that he's selling here. All landscapes are painted in plein air. He makes his own reproductions and offers them framed. On the back, there is a label that describes the subject and the materials used, and sometimes a little story about the painting. These reproductions are relatively inexpensive. Often, the original one of these is still available, if you ask. Upon retiring from a 27-year teaching career, Margaret Paul moved to the coast in pursuit of her artistic leanings. The first decade, she spent working with clay, doing ceramic mosaics, porcelain indoor tabletop water fountains, crochet textured tiles, and sculptures. Her interest in creating sterling flatware jewelry was sparked when she purchased a sterling spoon ring online and realized she could make a better one. Thanks to the Mendocino Art Center's jewelry open studio sessions, coupled with several metalsmithing workshops, Margaret had the prerequisite training needed to embark on her next art adventure, making jewelry out of sterling spoons and forks. Finding unique and beautiful flatware often involves travel, domestic and international. After nearly a decade, she still enjoys the process of finding a piece of sterling, deciding what to make out of it, and then creating it. For her, the fun part is when someone spots a piece, instantly bonds with it, and must have it. Spencer Brewer creates high whimsy, fantastical sculptures out of vintage or unusual objects, which hopefully inspire people with a sense of delight, surprise, and possibly awe. He is passionate about creating sculptures which beg viewers to wonder, was this real? Craftsmanship, wonder, curiosity, and humor are essential in his work while staying true to an original part's design. Spencer doesn't make his sculptures look old. They are old. Vintage parts, machines, instruments, and industrial era ephemera from the early 1800s through the 1920s are inspirations for his sculptures. Restoring and working on over 20,000 pianos, players, and pump organs made over the centuries has been an in-depth lens into how well-crafted and executed mechanisms were made. Spencer carries this craftsmanship persona to new, unexpected places in his sculptures. Ceramic artist Alexis Moyer is one of the original founders of Edgewater Gallery, helping to make the idea of this collective a reality. Alexis makes pieces with a whimsical flair, and her ceramic works can't help but bring a smile to your face. Whether it's an everyday object like a favorite coffee mug, or one of her majestic totem poles, her work brings out an inner joy in everyone who sees it. Alexis does a lot of special commission work for clients, capturing their personal story of the animals in their family in a timeless treasure, either as standalone animal sculptures or combined into a totem pole. She's always happy to talk to people about the possibilities. Happy L.A. Hyder is celebrating 50 years in photography. She exhibits her earliest film work through her latest digital pieces here at Edgewater. Happy filmed exclusively in black and white film from 1969 until a trip to Paris in 1997, where she switched exclusively to color film. She worked with a medium format Hasselblad until 2010 in Beirut, when the convenience of a small digital camera captured her focus and her well-used Hasselblad was ready for retirement. Self-taught, Happy intuitively had the ability to find a detail and the angles within the whole that bring an image to life. She feels her images are architectural, even in her nature work, and calls the 1950s Life magazine photographers her mentors and influencers. As she says, in 1969, gravitating to the camera for expression, I found a language, a way to present beauty in the ordinary, and the ordinary as extraordinary. Terry creates angel kites, each with its own distinct style, personality, and healing influence. Nothing excites her more than a person wanting one of her unique creations to help them on his or her life path. Children find them fascinating and comforting because the hearts on the kites glow in the dark after the lights go out. Terry sends peace and love to the world and all those around her with one-of-a-kind angel kites.